Hello, Leo. Welcome to your weekly forecast. This is your reading for the week ahead, May 23rd through the 29th, 2022, for all Leo suns, moons, risings, Leo's on the house cusp, those with their sun in the fifth house and Venus in Leo. You can watch this reading. Please do keep in mind these are general readings, so of course they may not resonate with you specifically. And as I always say, for the most accurate reading with the most accurate outcome, please do come get a personal private tarot reading from either me or your favorite tarot reader out there. For your reading today, my beautiful Leos, we are using the Thelema Tarot deck here. The publisher is Los Scarabeo. If you want more information, you can visit www.loscarabeo.com or visit Facebook Los Scarabeo Tarot. We're going to be clarifying court cards today and or any other card I need to clarify with this everyday oracle deck, otherwise known as the Vera, Sibilla, Italiana. This is also a Los Scarabeo product, so if you want more information, just visit his website. I'll also put these decks in the description box for you guys at the bottom. Oracle messages, we're using Oracle of Shadows and Light by Lucy Cavendish, artwork by Jasmine Beckett Griffith. There's no publisher on here, but if you want more information, you can just click screenshot that QR code, take a picture of that, and that will probably give you some more information. I'm putting that out there just in case, you know, people want to know information about the tarot decks. Okay. Leo, I'm not going to lie, you're my first reading today. Then we're going to do Virgo. Then if I have time, I'm going to do Libra today. So that is the lineup. Let's see what's going on for you guys over this next week. I feel like you guys are going to have a bomb-ass summer. I've seen a lot of travel plans, a lot of jet setting. I feel like it's going to be pretty awesome, actually. So I see a lot of travel in your future. I feel like some of you are going to be going to visit foreign countries. You could be, I don't know, flying around the world. I also definitely see someone out there taking like a very luxurious beach vacation somewhere tropical. So, yeah, I'm very excited for my Leos out there. So let's see what's coming down the pipeline for you guys. May 23rd through the 29th, 2022, all Leo suns, moons, risings, Leos on the house cusp, those with their sun in the fifth house, and Venus in Leo spirit. What's coming down the pipeline for Leo? Give me six cards for their week ahead. One more here. Like, share, comment, and subscribe, guys. If you aren't already subscribed to my channel, go ahead and hit that subscribe button right now. Click all notifications or turn on all notifications so you'll always be notified whenever I do upload your weekly forecasts. Much appreciated. Feel free to leave a comment down below. And Leo, underneath the deck, we do have the Nine of Swords reversed. Gemini's energy. Nine of Pentacles reversed. I see some kind of Virgo here. You could be dealing with a Virgo or a Gemini. This person looks very overwhelmed and codependent. There's your energy. We also have Aries here. Yeah, I feel like someone got kicked out of the house or someone is not welcome. I feel like this person is very stressed out because I'm not sure why. But there is this underlying theme or challenge of this week of someone being under stress, pressure. Yeah, like I said, it could be a Virgo here. Someone is very needy and codependent on you. Someone is very stressed about you. Someone is very much in their head worrying. Or this is you, Leo. Let's see. How you see yourself today, the Empress. Very nice. Venus energy, Taurus or Libra. You could have Taurus or Libra highly aspected, sun, moon, or rising. You see yourself as being well taken cared for, and also, you know, giving that energy back out into the world. The Empress says that you are abundant here. Some of you are going through a period of fertility. This could also just indicate, well, and some of you are going to be, some of you are pregnant here or are ready to conceive. But I also feel like here, this is you giving birth to life. And this could be in any area of your life. This could be creative projects. This could be actual human life. This could be just also a way of being in the world. For me, the Empress is a way of being in the world. It indicates abundance, attraction, beauty, and luxury. So what is the theme for your week ahead? We have the Page of Swords reversed. Well, it looks like you have someone spying on you this week. This could be some kind of a hater here, some kind of a troll. We have Gemini's energy here again. You might hear something through a third party here. Of course, we'll have to go in and clarify this card. We have air sign energy here, Libra, Gemini, Aquarius as your theme for the week ahead. Someone is spying, someone is hating, someone has something to say. It's probably not very nice. This could also be something, like I said, you hear through gossips the rumor mill or a third party here. And it's probably not going to be very nice here. This is an energy of someone that has a nasty attitude. So we'll go in and clarify him. Obviously, this could be someone who's younger than you, someone that's less mature, someone that doesn't, they're not very eloquent when they speak. It's kind of, this is more like someone that, I don't know, someone that just comes off the street here. They don't have, they're not a very sensible individual. In your past, you did learn a lesson regarding the Fool in reverse. Aries, well, this is a healthy amount of distrust here, or this is someone here that was acting recklessly, foolishly. I feel like this is someone that you didn't trust in your past, or someone that you probably still don't trust in your current situation. Yeah, I get the sense that there's someone around you this week, Leo, that you've already dealt with before. This person can't be trusted. They do things on a whim. They don't take calculated risks. They do stupid shit. So I feel like you could be, the cards are warning you that you might encounter a situation again this week where you can't trust what someone's saying. You can't trust what you're hearing. Because these are people, the Page of Swords reverse are people that don't cite their sources. They don't check their facts. These are people that just make stuff up because they have nothing better to do than to hate. Your challenge this week is the Temperance in reverse, Sagittarius. Well, your challenge is to remain calm and cool under pressure. I feel like someone is purposely trying to agitate you. I feel like someone's purposely trying to make you angry or to frustrate you. So you need to keep an even keel this week. Something is not jiving here. Something is not coalescing. Something is not coming together in an even or smooth manner. You could be dealing with a Sagittarius, I guess, as well. I'm feeling issues with agreeing with someone here or getting on the same page. This also has to do with a lack of healing here. So maybe you need to work on healing this week, or someone else around you does. Yeah, I see a lot of irritability here. I feel like someone's going to be purposely trying to get on your nerves. I don't feel like it's going to work. What is the lesson you're learning now? The Ten of Pentacles in reverse. Yeah, I feel like this is someone that got kicked out of your family, or someone that's going through some sort of exile here, or loss in money or long-term relationship, and they want to come and blame you for it, or they want to come and talk to you about it. This could be someone that just got out of a long-term relationship, or someone that has like lost their family, their home, their financial security, their emotional security. This is basically someone that has nothing. And so you're going to be learning about that this week. This could be a family member or someone that thinks that they were part of your tribe or your family or your soul group. I don't feel like they are. I feel like there's someone here that just has nothing better to do than to spy on you, copy you, hate on you. They're basically just a troll. So the gift you will receive is the Eight of Wands. Beautiful. So this is a lot of movement forward here. You could be taking a quick flight this week or sending out some communications here. Whatever is going on, things are going to happen quickly and they're going to move in your favor. So notice how all these wands are moving in the same direction here. So they're in alignment. I feel like you're in alignment, Leo. We also have Sagittarius's energy again here. If you are dealing with a Sagittarius, I feel like you could be hearing from them by the end of the week here. I feel like things are going to move quickly with this person. I feel like things are just really taking off for you. All right, so I wouldn't worry too much. I feel like most of this is outside influence type of stuff here. People are trying to attempt to influence you, but they're not going to be able to. Let's clarify the Page of Swords in reverse. Who's the Page of Swords reversed in Leo's environment this week? Notice I said environment. I meant theme for your week ahead. Why is the Page of Swords reversed the theme for Leo's week ahead, Spirit? Why is the Page of Swords reversed theme for Leo's week ahead? Clarify the Page of Swords reversed, please. We have the Costanza, the Old Woman, and the Nuptials. So it looks like there's an older woman here. This could be a mother, an aunt, a grandmother, or an old acquaintance. Yeah, I see that with the Ten of Pentacles in reverse here. This is someone that's no longer part of your life, but all they can do is spy on you. You've been this person's pillar. You've kind of been keeping an even keel with this person. You've been holding it together. You continue to put up with whatever this person's doing to you. Solid bond, union, alliance, the nuptials. Well, someone wants to put the ring on it here. So this could also be like, for example, a mother-in-law or a mother or a grandmother. Someone wants to form an alliance with you is what I'm getting. And, or this could be someone here that is friends of the family or something like that. This could be someone that wants to mend things with you, Leo. So it doesn't have to be romantic, obviously. They want to come together with you, but I would watch out for anyone that has slandering, gossiping, spying. Could be an air sign here. Doesn't have to be. I do pick up Gemini. Let's see. Clarify the Ten of Pentacles in reverse. Clarify the Ten of Pentacles in reverse. Yeah. Someone is alone here. Someone spending time alone. Because the stanza talks about intimacy, privacy, or solitude. It's like someone has their own room here. Someone's pastime is to go out, and this is kind of like the Three of Cups to me, this Alegreza, this joyous heart here. Someone's worried here. There's a woman who's worried or irritable or moody or troubled. I feel like this is someone that you are... That's like, for example, going through some sort of an exile here with their family or someone that's been kicked out of a social group here. I feel like this is someone that you just do not entertain anymore. So, looks like they're worried. Well, when you treat people terribly and you talk behind their back and you gossip and you participate in that kind of thing, what do you expect? Okay, what do you expect? I don't see a confrontation here though. Let's see, what is your advice for Leo this week? Sorry, that's my stomach. I was hungry and I ate lunch, but for some reason it's talking to me today. Advice for Leo. Poe, time for change. Learn something new. To use technology and gadgets with wisdom. I feel like you're interested in, you're ready for change here. You might be experimenting with technology. Grumpy red fairy, be true to yourself. And strange Valentine, love is strange. What the heck? Here's the Eight of Wands. They're saying just be yourself, Leo. Just do what you want. Proceed forward here. I don't know. I don't feel like you're grumpy. I feel like someone else is grumpy around you. I feel like someone else is having trouble being true to themselves. Maybe they're a narcissist, or maybe they don't know how to be normal. They don't know who they are, so they look to you for advice, or they spy on you. Strange Valentine, love is strange. I feel like you have a weird stalker. You have a stalker, Leo. I'm not sure what their issue is, or what they're I think you're just attractive, or you're attracting people in and from all walks of life. So just be careful. I don't really feel like you like this person. I feel like this person stresses you the F out. I don't know. I feel like this person thinks that they're your friend, or that they, you know, whatever. Underneath the deck, we have Storm Angel, collision of beliefs, styles, attitudes, and energies. Yeah, you couldn't be more different than this person. I feel like you don't agree with anything this person says or does. You don't even like this person. I don't know. Temperance in reverse. They want to cause drama. They want to stir stuff up. Just keep moving forward is what I have to say, Leo. So thank you for tuning in. This is your weekly forecast. Take care. I'll see you guys back next week.